Hey, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we're going to talk about the different units used in the United States for measuring the volume of liquids. When you hear the word gallon, you might think of a gallon of milk, those big plastic jugs of milk at the grocery store. And that is correct. Those jugs each hold 1 gallon of milk. A gallon is the largest unit used to measure the volume of liquids. Similarly to a gallon of milk, we also see quarts of milk in the grocery store. These are the tall cardboard containers. Each container holds exactly 1 quart of milk. A quart is the second largest unit used for measuring volume of liquids. A pint might be harder to visualize. Usually when you order a soda or a lemonade at a restaurant, it comes in a pint-sized glass. You can also buy pints of ice cream at the grocery store. A pint is the second smallest unit for measuring the volume of liquids. When someone says they need a cup of coffee, they really mean it. Most mugs are exactly 1 cup. A cup is the smallest unit of measurement for the volume of liquids. Now, how do these units all compare to each other? Here we have them ordered from largest volume to the smallest volume. Now let's look at how these units compare to each other numerically, or with values. Let's compare cups and pints. There are 2 cups in 1 pint. So we can say 2 cups is equal to 1 pint. Now let's compare pints to quarts. There are 2 pints in 1 quart. So we can say 2 pints is equal to 1 quart. Now let's compare quarts to gallons. There are 4 quarts in 1 gallon. So we can say 4 quarts is equal to 1 gallon. I use a little trick to remember this one. Quart sounds like quarter, and a quarter is 1/4. So there are 4 quarts in 1 gallon. Using the chart, how many pints fit in 6 cups? Well, if I know that 2 cups is equal to 1 pint, then for these 2 cups here, this will be equal to 1 pint, and these 2 here is equal to another 1 pint, and these 2 here are equal to another 1 pint. Excuse my bad drawings of pints. So if we add all of these pints up here, we have 3. So 6 cups equals 3 pints. How many gallons are in 8 quarts? So remember, these are quarts down here, and there's 4 is equal to 1 gallon. So over here, if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, here's 4 quarts. Those are equal to 1 big gallon of milk. And then I have another 4 down here, so that is equal to another gallon. So if I have 8 quarts, that is equal to 2 gallons. Now this one says, how many quarts are in 4 pints? So this is the quart here. 1 is equal to 2 pints. So here I have these 2 pints is going to be equal to 1 quart. And these 2 pints is going to be equal to 1 quart. So that would give me a total of 2 quarts is equal to 4 pints. So now this one says, how many cups are in 6 pints? So I need to find my conversion factor with cups and pints, and it says there's 2 cups in every 1 pint. So that means this 1 pint here is equal to 2 cups. So that means each of these is equal to 2 cups, 2 cups, 2 cups, all the way down the line. And so I could count the cups Or I can do a quick multiplication problem. I know that there's 2 for each of these. So 2 cups times how many pints again? That was 6. So that would give me 2 times 6, 12 cups. So there's 12 cups and 6 pints. Now you know the 4 units for measuring volume of liquids. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.